Okay, so welcome everybody to another FAQ video, and today we're going to touch a very hot topic, and it's about the physics settings in user mode. And this has been requested a lot of times, and finally it has arrived. So if you want to play user mode, you have different icons here at the game type, arcade, simulation, and user. You click on use and then it will actually activate the settings of user mode. There's also a video where I explain the difference between arcade, simulation, and user. For that video, check the description and it will link you to that video where we go into the fine details what the difference are between each of those game types. So check that video to find that out. But now we're going to move to the settings. So we are in the physics options and we have it on the basic tab. You start with the flipper gap on top. You can pick between small and normal. What is the space between the flippers? That's what this setting is. If you want to go to more like an arcade setting, you're gonna have a small flipper gap. If you want a bigger flicker gap, you're gonna go to simulation. Playfield tilt is the machine angle. So if you want a real fast pinball table, that's what you need to change here. If you want a slow pinball table, you're gonna change it to a lower value. So how quick is that machine? Flipper force is the force behind the flippers. You know, what's the strength on the flippers? Do you want to shoot really powerful shots? Or do you want more gentle touches on the flippers? That's the flipper force. And then we have the ball elasticity. That's the bounciness of the ball. How much does this ball bounce? Ball friction is the friction between the ball and the playfield. Obviously, no friction is a little bit like an, you know, like ice, where the ball really rolls really quickly, has no friction. And if you have more friction, well, that ball is going to grab the surface a lot more, and there's more friction. Slingshot force, quite obvious. You know, if the ball hits a slingshot, what's the power you get on the slingshot when it comes back? Same for bumper force, you know, how much force do you get on the bumpers? If you have low force, you're gonna get small feedback. You're gonna have high force, you're gonna get that high feedback. And you have a lot of force on the bumper and it shoots back with a lot more power. Ball velocity is quite interesting because this is the acceleration of the ball, where, you know, how quick does that ball go from 0 to 100? Just like a car, really. How quick does it go from 0 to 100 miles an hour? That's what this setting is. We're moving to the advanced step. Here we have the plunger force, which is the mechanism that shoots the ball into the playfield. How strong do you want that plunger? Want it really soft or hard? That's what this setting does. Flipper tap pass. Well, that's a setting where it decides how quick that flipper moves up and down. How quick does it move from the bottom position to the top position? That is the flipper tap pass. Slingshot sensitivity. Well, the ball drops down in a slingshot. Will it activate or trigger? Yes or no? Kind of depends on the force. So if you have a really soft hit on the slingshot, it could trigger or not, depending on how sensitive you set the slingshot. So you can put it really sensitive, it will pick anything up. If you decrease it, then you actually find it doesn't trigger at everything. So that's what the slingshot sensitivity does. Tilt sensitivity, sort of the same. When does the machine tilt? If you wanted to have it like the simulation mode, where it's a little bit tricky to nudge and it triggers quite quick and goes to tilt, well, then you have to be more strict than with arcade, where you don't get tilt. Yeah, that's tilt sensitivity. How quick does that machine tilt? And the last one is the nudge force. How much power do you put into that nudge? How much movement do you get out of it? That's a nudge force. So those are the 5 settings in the advanced step. With that being said, we're moving to the end of the video. And I would like to share a couple things still. First of all, you need a bronze spec on Steam to do this. On some other platforms, it might work differently, but on Steam, you need a bronze spec to play around with these custom physics. The second thing is what a lot of players don't know. If you're going to play a game and you're going to the settings and you have the playfield tilt really high like this, and we're just going to demonstrate that. So we have a fastball and it moves really fast. If we then go back and change it,
award.
Suddenly,
student,
that ball is super slow. This actually means that the settings are updating live. What you change in the options comes back directly. So you don't have to restart the game to change the settings. And this is why the user mode leaderboard shouldn't be taken that seriously, because everybody plays with different settings. It's almost not possible to compare it because everybody plays a little bit different. Which is different than arcade and simulation, because then everybody has the same settings. So user mode has been always there a little bit to play with your own settings, to try it, you know, break your own records. So if you want to have strict settings on how to play, then you stick with arcade and simulation. If you want to try out stuff, then you go to the user mode. With that being said, I'll see you next time in the FAQ.